Hello everyone, I am Karan Kapil with today's virtual teacher. Today we are going to discuss another metabolic process, that is respiration. Respiration means to oxidatively break down the nutrients, or you can say food, that you intake in the body for the release of energy. Many of us think that respiration means just intake of oxygen and exhale of carbon dioxide, but it is not true. Intake of oxygen and exhale of carbon dioxide is known as breathing. It is not respiration. What does respiration mean? It means oxidative breakdown of food to release energy. Okay, so now respiration is of two types on the basis of requirement of oxygen. If oxygen is required, then that kind of respiration is known as aerobic respiration. And if the oxygen is not required, then that kind of respiration is known as anaerobic respiration. बेटा आप सबको पता होना चाहिए दैट एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन अकर्स इन यूकैरियोटिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स दोज हु हैव अ वेल डेफिनाइड बॉडी और यू कैन से वेल डेफिनाइड सेल स्ट्रक्चर वेयर एज एनारोबिक रेस्पिरेशन टेक प्लेस इन सिंपल ऑर्गेनिजम्स और इन ड्रास्टिक कंडीशंस ओके सो इन एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इफ वी टॉक अबाउट एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन It is the breakdown of food by utilizing oxygen. Okay, so food in general for every cell, the food is glucose. So here, glucose is the respiratory substrate. As you know, the chemical formula C6H12O6. It is a 6-carbon compound. Now, as it enters the cytoplasm and reacts with the oxygen, it results in the formation of pyruvate, which itself is a 3-carbon compound. Now, this is a 6-carbon compound. It is a 3-carbon compound. Here, 2 pyruvate will be formed and energy will also be released. Now, this pyruvate will enter a very special component of cell, that is mitochondria. As you all know, it is a powerhouse of cell, and now we are going to know why it is known as powerhouse of the cell. As pyruvate enter mitochondria, it results in the formation of CO2 as a byproduct, water also as a byproduct, and energy. For every living cell, energy is in form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. And how many ATP is forming? 38 ATP. That's why here too much amount of energy is producing. That's why it is producing in mitochondria. That's why mitochondria is known as powerhouse of the cell. Now, if we talk about anaerobic respiration, here oxygen is not required. Now we talk about anaerobic respiration. Here oxygen is not required. Other respiratory, or you can say other oxidative substances can also be there. Now aerobic respiration is also of two type depending upon the end product. What is the end product forming? If the end product is forming is alcohol, then it is known as alcoholic fermentation. Or if the end product forming here is lactic acid, then it is known as lactic acid producing anaerobic respiration. So firstly, we will talk about alcoholic fermentation. Again, the respiratory substrate here is also glucose, C6H12O6. Glucose, food for every cell. Now again, it enters into the cytoplasm of the cell and form pyruvate. It is common, okay? In every respiratory reaction, this step, glucose ka conversion pyruvate ke andar, it is a universal process. It occurs everywhere, in every cell. Now pyruvate along with small amount of energy is also produced here. Now, as it is occurring in a simpler cell, in a prokaryotic cell, so there is no well differentiation of anything. So again, the pyruvate will not enter any cell organelle. It remains in the cytoplasm, and now it will result in the formation of ethanol. Ethanol is alcohol, drinking alcohol. That's why it is known as alcoholic fermentation. Ethanol will be formed along with 2 CO2. And again here 2 ATP will be formed. Only small amount of energy is formed. That's why it is not a good reaction to be occur in a cell. Ethanol is a 2-carbon compound. So here 2 are 4-carbon and 2 of the carbon dioxide will become 6-carbon, which will now be balanced. Now this ethanol which is formed can be extracted in the brewers industries. It can be used in the formation of wine, beers, etc. Okay, now we are talking about lactic acid producing anaerobic respiration. The initial steps will be same. The glucose will enter into the cytoplasm of the cell and form 2-pyruvate along with a small amount of energy. And now this pyruvate, in lack of oxygen in a human body or in any organism body, in the muscle cell, it will result in the formation of lactic acid, which is also 3-carbon compound. So 2 lactic acid will be formed along with 2 ATP. This is a reaction which occur in every organism's muscle cell when they are in an extensive exercise stage. In extensive exercise, energy requirement of the body is too high, but the oxygen intake is not that sufficient. So there will be lack of oxygen in the muscle cell. It will result in the formation of lactic acid, which will result in the formation of strains in the muscle. Muscle pain hona shuru ho jayega beta. Agar ye reaction lung mein time tak chalti rehti. So this is another type of anaerobic respiration known as lactic acid forming anaerobic respiration. If we talk about ATP, adenosine triphosphate, it is the energy currency of cell and it forms in mitochondria. Okay, so we have discussed about 3 type of respiration, mainly aerobic respiration, alcoholic fermentation and lactic acid forming anaerobic respiration. The best is the best respiration reaction is aerobic respiration. Now, respiration occurs in every organism at a particular place, and that place is known as respiratory surface. There are some special qualities of the respiratory surface. It should be thinner, so that easy diffusion can take place. It should be moist, it should be highly vascular, and it should have large surface area. These 4 basic qualities should be present in every respiratory surface. Like in humans, the respiratory surface is alveoli. So if anyone asks you, give the 4 characteristic feature of alveoli, then it will be, it is thin, it is moist, it is highly vascular, and the last thing here is large surface area. Smaller organisms respire through the plasma membrane. So these 4 features will also present in their plasma membrane. Some organisms have book gills, book lungs, or some respire through trachea. Many other things are there. They all have these 4 features common in all them. Okay. Now, if we talk about respiration in plants, so respiration in plants occur via the same methods, via the same chemical reactions, but the place through which the gases are being exchanged are different. So if we talk about roots of plant, in roots of plant, there is direct diffusion of gases. The first reaction that we talked about, aerobic respiration, that reaction occurs in every cell. So for the intake of oxygen, they perform diffusion. Outside, the oxygen pressure is high, inside the cell oxygen pressure is low. So the oxygen moves from higher pressure to the lower pressure. Whereas inside the cell, the carbon dioxide concentration is very high. Whereas in outside atmosphere, the carbon dioxide concentration is not that much. So it will just diffuse out. Now if we talk about stem have a thick covering of, you can say, cuticle, okay, or suberin. So that's why the free movement of gases will not be there. So there are lenticels, specialized cells that perform breathing action. Now in leaves, there are stromatal pore, stromata, which is guided by guard cells, which help in the diffusion of gases. In daytime, what happened? The rate of photosynthesis is very high. So oxygen is being released, but carbon dioxide is not getting released. But in nighttime, what happened? The photosynthesis ceased, stopped. So there will be no oxygen production, but still carbon dioxide is forming. Respiration is a continuous process which happens in all living organisms, in all living cells. So in daytime, in day, only oxygen will be there. Oxygen will be in adequate amount. But in night time, oxygen will not be there. Only high amount of carbon dioxide will be observed around the large trees. Okay. So that's why it is in general saying that in night time, we should not go towards the, big trees, because there is high concentration of CO2 around them. If we talk about human respiratory system, it starts from nose. The nasal pores act as a, you can say, pathway for the entry of oxygen, or you can say atmospheric gases to the body. From the nostrils, it goes to nasal passage, which leads to pharynx, which leads to larynx, then trachea, it is known as windpipe, then bronchioles and bronchi. Bronchi are the terminals at which balloon-like small structures are there. Balloon-like small structures can be seen at the end of bronchioles. These small balloon-like structures are known as alveoli. As we all know, it is the respiratory surface where exchange of gases will take place. It is highly vascular, so blood will continuously be flowing around them, and from the blood, the carbon dioxide is being removed out and oxygen is being liberated inside the blood. So many students are confused at how this mechanism takes place. So we will just simply think about this. There are three subsequent columns. Okay, this is alveoli. This is blood. And this is body cells. So what will happen in alveoli is oxygen is getting inside it. So in alveoli, there is high concentration of oxygen. That means oxygen is very high. As it diffuses out to the alveoli, in blood there is a special pigment known as hemoglobin. So what happened? Hemoglobin, when combined with oxygen, it becomes oxyhemoglobin. Okay, if you write the, you can say normal formula, HbO4. Oxyhemoglobin. Now oxyhemoglobin migrate in the blood, and when it reaches the tissue, as we know, tissue can the CO2 concentration is very high, but oxygen concentration is very low. So what happens? As this oxidized hemoglobin comes in the contact with cell, oxygen goes inside the cell and hemoglobin again become free. Now this oxygen will react with glucose, and now what form? Carbon dioxide, water and energy. This carbon dioxide will come out of the tissue, or you can say cell. It migrates in the blood in two ways. First, it combines with hemoglobin and form carboxamine hemoglobin, and that carboxamine hemoglobin will again go to the alveoli. In alveoli, the carbon dioxide pressure is very low, so CO2 is released inside it and hemoglobin again become free. But what happened to the majority of carbon dioxide? As we know, air, water is also formed. It will form bicarbonate ion H2CO3, which will migrate to the alveoli and again form CO2 plus water. So you are saying here that oxygen is being transported to the tissue and carbon dioxide is being liberated out. And what will be the advantage of this water vapor? As you all know, alveoli should be moist. So this water will be used to keep the alveolar surface moist to facilitate the diffusion. So through which you can just simply think about how gases are being transported inside the body. Now there is mechanism of breathing. You can say how the breathing mechanism, yani intake of oxygen and exhale of carbon dioxide, is taking place. So firstly, we will make a very rough diagram of human thoracic cavity. Human thoracic cavity is guided by diaphragm, which is a muscular, you can say, platform. Now what happened? If we want to inhale gases, like we want to inhale oxygen, so what will happen? This, you can say, the diaphragm, which is a platform, it will relax. It will contract, which will result in increasing the volume of thoracic cavity. As think about this, this is the diaphragm normal, you can say, situation. When we want to inhale, it become contract, straight. So what will happen? The upper volume of the thoracic cavity will increase, and as the volume increase, the pressure decreases. Volume increases, then pressure decreases. So what will happen? Outside pressure is normal, but inside pressure is very low. So what will happen? The gases move from high pressure to low pressure. Here ribs also, ribs have a very important function here. Ribs, in with the help of intercostal muscles, they also move upward, so that there will be a secondary increase of the volume. So as the volume increases, the pressure decreases and the gases moves inside the thoracic cavity. Now, as it moves inside from alveoli, it will go into the exchange, as we talked earlier. So what will happen? Now, The diaphragm becomes contracted. The ribs, with the help of intercostal muscles, moves outside. So the total volume of the thoracic cavity increases, result in the movement of air from high pressure to low pressure, means inside the body. Now we want to exhale. So what will happen? The diaphragm, which was previously flattened, it now become domed shaped. Domed shaped means relaxed. So what will happen? The volume become less. Intercostal muscles also move backward, so the total volume of the thoracic cavity also decreases to a particular extent. So what will happen? Now the volume decreases, then pressure increases, and here is high pressure, here is the normal pressure. So what will happen? The air will move outside. So this is the general mechanism of respiration. So I hope you will get it. If you have any kind of doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. So all the best to everyone. And stay safe in the home. Thank you.